Have you ever gotten into the backseat of a car? Only to discover that you're feeling a little bit strange. Something is not quite right. In fact, you're feeling a little bit queasy and a little bit nauseous. If that's you, then welcome to the world of motion sickness. Welcome back. In this video, I'm going to share my experiences in dealing with motion sickness. I personally have had motion sickness ever since I can remember. It goes as far back as being a kid in school. I remember my mom taking me to school in the car, and she used to also drive a few other kids to carpool them to school. That was kind of like a little side business that she had. And I recall a lot of the kids over the years just doing homework in the car, studying, catching up on different things, school-related work in the car while it was moving. And I noticed that for the life of me, I could not do it. I tried. I remember one time I had to study a little bit extra for a test that morning. And the night before, I felt I didn't study enough, and I tried to cram in as much as I could that morning on the way to school in the backseat of my mom's car. And I'll tell you, it was rough. I remember I had to put the book down. I couldn't study. I couldn't even look at my notes because I almost immediately got queasy and extremely nauseous at times. And this is a symptom of motion sickness. Through the years, I thought it maybe had something to do with my eyes, my ears. I thought it was in my mind. Other kids that I knew didn't have it. Even though I know this affects quite a few people, nobody that I knew had it. So no one could. I couldn't relate to anybody with this, and they used to just tell me it was in my mind. But over the years, I just learned to recognize the things that cause it and how to manage and deal with my motion sickness. Another example of dealing with motion sickness and just experiencing it in real world situations is when I went on vacation and I did my first snorkeling excursion, where I actually went on a small boat, and me and a group of friends and some other people were on this boat. You know, we went out, a little bit of a ways into the ocean, and we would, stop by a spot where there was a reef, and it was beautiful. You could even see from the boat itself. The water was so clear. You could see fish, you could see reef, a lot of colors, and it was great. And in the excitement, I forgot about my motion sickness on that trip. I didn't have any symptoms at that point during that trip. And again, I didn't think anything of it. I was just so excited to get into the water that I immediately dove into the water with my snorkel and my mask, and I was fine. However, things started to change when I got back on the boat and we started to head back to shore. This is when I got into trouble. As the boat was coming back to shore, I saw the shoreline far in the distance, and in my mind, I was already thinking, wow, this is gonna take a few minutes to get to the pier that the boat was gonna park at so we can get off. And it was at that point that I realized I was actually getting motion sickness. I didn't want to be sick on the boat. So what I did was I dove into the water and I just started swimming back to shore. I was able to get there swimming with no problem. But I did notice that the entire rest of the day and part of the following day, I was actually feeling a little bit queasy and suffering some lingering effects of the motion sickness. So these are examples of motion sickness and how real this can be and how bad it can affect some people. And for me, it's hit or miss. Sometimes I get it and sometimes I don't, but it's unpredictable. Another common time for me to get motion sickness is on a plane. Now, in the past, I would try to do what everybody else does on a plane. They get they buy a magazine at the airport and they read it on the plane. I tried to do that, got motion sickness, and that kind of messed me up for the whole flight. Never got sick, but I got to the point where I felt really bad, and it was just an unpleasant feeling to be traveling and not being able to enjoy the trip because you're just feeling terrible. Then other people take out their iPads, they take out their phones, they start, you know, reading stuff on there. I tried that, didn't work, same result. I got sick, a feeling of being sick, the motion sickness was kicking in again, didn't work. Then I also tried, okay, I'm gonna try looking at the monitor and watch a movie in the plane that was right in front of me. So sometimes I would fly JetBlue and they had the TV screens right in front of me. So I didn't even have to look away. I would look right in front of me. And at that point, I realized that that was a little better. I didn't really get motion sickness that much doing that, but I did notice a little bit of motion sickness creeping in, even using that strategy of just watching a movie and looking directly in front of me. So the bottom line is, if you're the type of person that gets motion sickness, then just be aware that there are things you can do to manage it. Here's what I did to manage it and reduce it and eliminate it in many circumstances. Now, it's not completely gone, but from the research that I've done, that I have done in the past, and I've spoken to doctors about this, I am not a doctor, do not listen to me, talk to your doctor. But my understanding is, in talking to doctors and people that are you know, familiar with how motion sickness works, the symptoms, pharmacists that prescribe things for motion sickness all the time, my final conclusion from what everybody has told me, I don't think anybody really knows how motion sickness is caused, what makes some people have it and some people not have it. There's, you know, things that have to do with the inner ear, I've heard, and your equilibrium and your eye, your sinuses. So I've heard a couple of different things, and I think that's correct, but no one really actually knows exactly what causes motion sickness. I think that's still kind of a mystery. And as a result, there's not really a definitive cure for it. There's only treatments, things that you can do to reduce the symptoms temporarily. But I find that my way of managing it has worked for me, and I'm going to share it with you right now. First of all, when you're on a plane or on a bus or any kind of a moving vehicle, if you are not looking straight ahead, you're going to be in trouble if you are vulnerable to motion sickness. So avoid turning your head, avoid looking down, avoid looking up. Try to look dead straight ahead if possible, as much as you can. Avoid shaking your head around too much. Just look straight ahead. This sounds extremely boring to do, especially on a lengthy trip, a lengthy plane ride or a train ride. But I found that if I look straight ahead, okay, it doesn't have to be exactly straight, but don't look to the side too much. Just look straight ahead. The motion sickness is less likely to occur. The other thing that helps a lot when I'm in a car, say, for example, I'm in a rental car or I'm in my car, you know, the main thing there for me is, if I am in any seat other than the driver's seat, I almost always get a little bit of motion sickness. And sometimes it can be pretty severe depending on how bumpy the ride is and how the person drives. Now, the best way that I have found to mitigate these symptoms and to really make it so that I do not get them is by driving. So if I drive the car, so obviously if I'm driving my own car or if it's a rental car, if I am the driver, typically I will almost never get motion sickness because for the most part, two things are happening here. First of all, I'm in control. My mind is preoccupied with something. So I think that may have something to do with it, but in combination with the fact that I'm also looking straight ahead as I'm driving, that makes motion sickness almost like a non-event for me at that point. I don't really get it. The other thing that I do is when I'm in the airport and I'm getting ready to board a plane, right out of the gate, obviously I'm not driving, I'm in a plane. It can be bumpy, it might not, it's unpredictable. What I have done in the past is drink a cup of coffee at the airport before I get on the plane. And for some reason, obviously, it may have something to do with the caffeine. I am not a doctor, so I don't know exactly. It may have something to do with the caffeine. But it also, a contributor to this is that since I am not a coffee drinker, it's possible that my receptors are very in tune to the caffeine dose of a cup of coffee, and I have a very low tolerance, and I'm able to get a healthy effect from the caffeine as far as whatever chemical reaction is being caused in the body by the caffeine that helps me with motion sickness. In other words, it prevents the motion sickness. And that's in combination with me practicing the method of looking kind of straight ahead, not turning sideways, not doing any kind of reading or writing on the plane. So in doing these activities with drinking coffee, I found that almost always I have success with reducing or eliminating motion sickness on those trips. Another thing that I do is make sure that I'm hydrated. I do notice that I get less motion sickness when I am well hydrated in the airport. Now, obviously that means that you may have to use the bathroom in the plane a couple of times because you're gonna drink a lot of fluids, but if you're hydrated, I think that also helps. But again, you consult your doctor. I am not a doctor. You gotta deal with your own motion sickness and ask your professional, because who knows, it could be something else that's causing the motion sickness. And you wanna make sure that you deal with it the correct way, and getting a proper diagnosis from your doctor is the best. I'm just giving you my experience with motion sickness that, as far as I know, is only motion sickness, not related to any other health problem. So the other thing that I do to help me with my motion sickness is get a lot of rest. I make sure that whenever I go on a trip, I have noticed this, that the few times that I've gone on a trip where I have not gotten any rest the night before, that's a situation where I almost always do get some or a lot of motion sickness. So definitely you're gonna want to get a lot of rest, hydrate, drink a cup of coffee. At least for me, that works. If you're a big coffee drinker, I don't know if the coffee thing is gonna work for you because maybe you have a high tolerance for it. But because I don't drink coffee on a regular basis, I'm not a big coffee drinker. Maybe for me, somehow the caffeine does something to me. Or maybe it's just because it is a liquid and it's hydrating in a sense, because I'm drinking a cup of water that has coffee in it. So the combination of these factors, I think, is something that maybe the average person can do. That this doesn't involve any medical or prescription drugs of any kind. But I will leave you with this final tip, and that is, if your doctor advises you to do it, I know these are over the counter, but I asked my doctor first before I did this. The doctor did advise me to try Dramamine. I just followed the advice of my doctor and I did try Dramamine a few times, and I did notice that it did work a little bit. Now, I don't know if it was because I did the other things as well, because I did try to do everything else, looking straight ahead, drinking a cup of coffee, staying hydrated, sleeping good the night before. So I don't know exactly what caused what or if it was a combination, but having the Dramamine, I did feel a little bit of drowsiness when I had the Dramamine. So maybe the Dramamine is doing something where it's just numbing your body down in general, and it's causing you to be desensitized to a lot of things, including motion sickness. So hey, if it works, it works. I did it. Now, I don't do it a lot, only because if I'm getting success doing the other things that don't involve taking any kind of medication, then I tend to want to stick with that. But I have tried Dramamine in the past, and it has, I think, worked for the most part. I've never really felt that it didn't work, and I felt a little bit of drowsiness, and it actually made my time in the airplane a little bit easier, because I was able to not really sleep, but I was able to relax a little more on the plane. So those are my tips, guys, and my experiences dealing with motion sickness. Hope you guys got something out of it, and I will see you in the next video, guys. Stay safe out there.